the razor's edge, motherfuckers!
Ah, no comment.
No comment on that
one. I don't even want to say anything about that.
What were you going to say about razor's edges, Trott?
I had no comment.
Well, you were thinking of one, though, weren't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, but I had no comment.
Fucking hell, Trott.
Got very...
Speak your mind.
Empowered thoughts.
Empowered thoughts about razor's edges.
See you guys later. I'm doing a different track thing.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you're going back again.
In the backwards thing. He loves the little nuggets of secret.
I like the little nuggets.
You in this game and your nugs.
I love
Chris
the
Trott.
Nugs.
Trott, why do you get nugs?
What?
I don't know.
Why do you get nugs?
Leave me alone.
What are you asking him? You don't even know what you're saying half the time.
Half the time?
Most. Let's be honest.
True. I want to hear what your more opinions
fuck it, I'll do the
about
track.
Space and
the final
Venus.
Venus?
Yeah.
There's nothing Venus. More to say.
We've said to say. Everything there needs to be said. Right?
Not everything.
Yeah.
There's a lot more you could be that could be said.
Venus is boring now.
Can you even prove that it exists, Trott?
What? Of course.
Yeah. Well, how? Have you been there?
I haven't been there.
Oh, so you haven't...
Solid. It's a pretty solid
so
argument.
You haven't seen it for yourself, then?
Have you looked
have
in
you touched it?
Telescope, Trott?
No, we can't believe everything we see, Trott.
We can't believe our
eyes.
We need
to actually be there.
Taste it.
And taste it, feel it.
I put most import on the sense of taste when yeah. proving things are real
Me
or not.
Me too.
Yeah.
So
especially
I like
potential
when,
mates.
When I have a big poop, I'm like, did I?
Did I? Do a big, let me just get down there.
Could be a quantum shit.
Really check
oh,
out.
It is quantum.
The,
it's quantum
is,
and it was never there.
Yeah, it's a Schrodinger's shit.
It's Schrodinger's
shit. God, it went down the
shit like matter until I
lift. G4, I finished first! Until fuck I, you both!
So I lift the lid of the toilet. It's shit like matter.
Just taking a cheeky dump and tasting it.
Is it in there? Is it not in there? I'm just going to close the lid and let somebody else define what is real.
Well, because we've been through the whole reality thing in the past.
Oh, numerous fucking times, mate.
Numerous times.
Too
plenty
much.
Of times.
Too often.
Too many
none
times.
Of us know
none of us
what
know
what we're talking about either.
I think I know now.
Do you think you know?
I think
what
I know.
What the fuck am I stuck on?
How do you know that we're not robots?
Fuck!
That were built by robots.
Yeah.
I know we are, Ross.
And now we're building robots.
We're intricate machines.
Elon Musk says we're in a simulation, and I'm inclined to believe him.
Yeah.
Does he say that, though?
Yeah, he said that. He said it's a very, very slim chance that we're not in a computer simulation.
Thank you, Elon.
I think it must be really
easy. He's been programmed well.
It must be really easy for incredibly successful rich people to believe things aren't real. Because
yeah,
I imagine
it's just
like
everything's come easier potentially or not
they've
necessarily.
They've got these insane lives. They're just like, why
me? It's like,
me?
Fuck, yeah, like I'm on a pedestal here.
Yeah.
It's
like Tom Cruise and people like that,
you
know, being a Scientologist.
Next time?
Like,
yeah.
It's just like... Yeah, it's just like, well, yeah, my life is incredible. It's absolutely
it makes
nuts.
Sense
like,
that yeah. all these amazing things happen to me because of some
well, yeah, thing. Like, you're not ill. You're not, like, you yeah. know, maybe all your family are healthy and you're wealthy. You can get anything you want at the touch of a button.
You can become president
and, yeah,
pretty
yeah,
easy.
Yeah, and maybe reality does slip from you a little
yeah,
bit.
Yeah, I'm sure it does.
This but, is a very interesting
I saw,
line of thought,
did you guys
gentlemen?
See his talk on the new solar tiles?
Yeah.
And stuff. It was really interesting.
Fucking
I mean,
loved
he,
it.
I don't know if he's a very good speaker.
He's a
no,
terrible
he's not.
Speaker.
He yeah. was very unsure of a lot of things he was saying.
Yeah.
And that kind of
I think it's just
put down.
But that in a way people like.
I guess so, yeah. It's not
like.
Scripted. Yeah, it's yeah. not like. It's like he's just ripping
it's
off the top.
It's endearing in a way because it feels authentic, but at the same time
yeah.
it's fucking annoying.
I remember yeah. watching it. It was kind of awkward. I was like, oh, I'm not sure if he's tanking here. Like,
yeah.
There was a cringe factor to it.
The thing is like. The proof is in the products, right?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Ultimately,
holy shit.
He's not playing up
how
anything.
How amazing are the, like,
those
the
tiles?
Those tiles
awesome.
All look like, you know, proper tiles and
I don't
stuff.
Know how they
I think
do it.
That was one thing that kind of puts you off. I know that a lot of people are like, oh, yeah, but solar power, like, it doesn't matter what it looks like.
Yeah.
But ultimately, people's design decisions on their houses
need,
will be affected
yeah.
by it.
You don't need to worry anymore.
And,
you
yeah, it looked really cool.
Tiles that are solar panels.
It's
crazy.
It's a nice step, you know. I don't know how much it costed in the end. How much was it?
So no quite
for a roof.
Thousands, yeah. tens of thousands.
The
thing is, like, what's really cool is if you bought right into the Tesla ecosystem, so
yeah.
you had the car, you had the roof
oh,
tiles,
yeah.
you had the battery
oh, yeah.
pack,
keep
right?
talking.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
You would have a self-sufficient home. Like
yeah.
they're saying that it's cheaper
off the grid
to run
solar-powered vibrators.
It, yeah, than to
oh,
run
yes.
Off the grid.
Yeah.
It's
well, pretty, you didn't you end up pay, giving back to the grid? And
you
they
can,
pay you a
yeah,
small
you,
amount.
So,
right?
I mean, that's a you can do that with existing solar
yeah.
panels as well.
Yeah.
But yeah. And also, it just, you know, you can charge your car. You don't have to pay for fuel. Literally, you're generating from the sun. And also it's clean. You know, that's really awesome that you're actually contributing to reducing these emissions that everybody's talking about.
I just really want them to make a good looking car. I really don't like the way the current cars look.
The Tesla's not great looking.
But it's a step in the right, it's a step in the right direction.
What? Fucking gorgeous car.
Really?
God, it's the best car in the world.
I don't know.
I don't think it's that bad, but it's
very basic.
Yeah, it's very pedestrian.
But it's a start, isn't it? They've got to start somewhere. And
I really fucking like.
Eventually, they'll come up with like more like sporty looking models that look kind of more impressive and kind of. But right now, I guess they're trying to appeal to a big market of kind of consumers who just want a car that takes them from A to B.
Hot shit.
Literally.
I mean,
itself.
Like I've been in one. Attracts my eye. Like inside of them, and they're kind of plasticky inside.
You've been in one? Yeah.
Interiors aren't great.
The interiors aren't great. The externals aren't great. They look a bit like a Ford Mondeo, a new look Ford Mondeo.
Don't say that.
They do, because Ford took the aesthetic stylings.
Why are you so offended by this?
Because I'm just saying.
He's just really like.
They're not bad cars, but for 90 grand.
Well, that's it. But obviously, you're paying for the technology. You're not paying for the look.
That's right. If you look at a new look Ford Mondeo, right? They bought Aston Martin and they started taking all the styling.
Don't show him. Right. Don't show it to him.
It does look a little bit like somewhere between a Jag.
It does look like a Jag.
But not like
that.
A nice Jag, not like a new, you know, like a SVR or something like that. Well, because it's just, if you look at the stylings of it, it is very pedestrian.
I love the front of the Tesla. I think it looks amazing. The back's not great.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure they'll make various models in the future once they've actually, you know, really.
I don't think they need to, Ross. I think they're perfect car design.
Of course, yeah, you're right, John.
Elon, take me.
Take me
to Mars.
Well, the 30 grand one they came up with recently, which was like the. Was it a hatchback or was it a smaller car? It was a smaller like, family car.
And it had the vertical doors.
Model 3, is that right, Trott?
Yeah, that's right.
Model 3. Trott, you're a resident expert on Tesla.
Oh, fuck, my controller's gone.
We still need to buy more cables, mate. These cables are so shit. Anchor.
No.
They keep fucking up on us.
Oh.
Yeah, that one looks all right. But yeah, ultimately the technology's there and that's what's more impressive
about
it overall. And I'm excited to see where it goes because I think I'd love to have an electric car.
Yeah. The range isn't still very good on them though.
Especially with the speed that they go as well. That sounds really impressive.
300 miles. How much more do you want?
They're not 300 miles.
Yeah.
Very low.
They're 220 miles.
That's pretty fucking
fast. No, it's not. It's not.
It's not really, Trott. Like, not.
It's not at all. Right? My car, for example, will do 500 miles on a full tank, right?
Mine's like a gas guzzler and like it runs out really fucking quickly. Like, and that'll take you 350.
Yeah. And that, like, if you think about this, I drove up to just north of Manchester, and that was about 180 miles either way, right? But I could do that all on a single tank, no problem.
Yeah, but
with the Tesla,
same time,
you have to stop and wait half an hour, right? That trip already takes almost 4 hours, right?
No,
adding the time.
Think about what you're saying, right?
I made
it within 180 miles. You could just leave the car there charging overnight. It's fine. You're done. You did your journey.
But
you don't have to stop anywhere.
But this is another thing. 220 miles is in optimum condition.
Fucking controller.
If it's cold and if you're putting your foot down, it reduces it.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I've had anecdotes from somebody who owns one and he told me about it.
He said,
as soon as you put your foot down, over 70 miles an hour, which you shouldn't be doing, but people do it, you know.
Yeah.
Over 70 miles an hour, your mileage drops substantially.
But you're saying at 70 miles an hour it still maintains that 220, right?
Well, no, it depends on the temperature as well. If it's a cold day, because it's a lithium ion batteries, cold day it reduces their effectiveness.
I literally can't play right now.
What are you saying the plan was? Oh, Trott, you're
none of this
giving
is
everyone
good.
A terrible viewing experience.
Right. Anyway, back in. Hi, Trott can actually control it now. I'm using a keyboard, which is incredibly difficult.
I've lost my train of thought.
What were you talking about? Range and lithium ion batteries.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Like
you were saying that
it's just not ideal yet.
Your friend likes to drive over 70 miles an hour and it ruins the
battery.
I think
it's more than adequate. It's not great, but it's more than adequate.
Ultimately, it's a great start.
That's a 200-mile journey.
Pretty often, to be fair. I drove down to Plymouth the weekend before. It depends on your driving habits. Like, I drove down to Plymouth the week before, which is 200 miles.
More importantly, sometimes you can't always park somewhere where there's a charging pole.
Yeah,
or like
my flat wouldn't.
So that's the only downside right now. But then obviously you've got to start somewhere.
Yeah,
and
it's good that people are doing it.
It will happen.
Yeah.
Like, I really don't get me wrong. I would fucking love one, but I really would.
Sounds like you hate Elon Musk personally.
I'm playing the devil's advocate, like I always like to do. But I would fucking love one of those cars. The speed they can go is unbelievable. The acceleration is just insane.
Well, you keep it under 70 though, yeah, of course.
Yeah,
of course.
Of course
you would.
Get to 70 in like
dangerous, reckless
3 seconds.
Like, how fast did I get there? That was amazing.
But and also, like, you know, the tech integration, the big screens on them are really cool.
That's what I like. It's just the fact that it's all just electric and
I just wish they had, they need bigger range. And I don't know how they're going to do it because lithium ion batteries can only be made so small at the moment. Like, you know, it's a limitation.
Well, apparently the next model's going to have the solar panel technology in the roof.
Yeah, that's pretty fucking cool.
So you just leave it outside and it charges itself.
That's amazing, isn't it? See, this is the thing. All these cars are designed for fucking California. Like,
yeah,
well,
right.
No, if you watch the presentation,
yeah,
you're saying like skies. England,
yeah,
it's always cloudy. And he said, well, also it's a very lush green country, and how do plants do photosynthesis? It's diffuse light. You may not get the sunlight, however the majority of the energy from the sun is still present.
Okay, cool.
So
there you go, the technology's there.
Just because you can't see it, the visible light.
So yeah, so we'll start a GoFundMe where we
all get Teslas,
and
then Patreon,
and just tell you what they're like, and then we'll just use them in our daily lives, and you won't really see most of that. But the GoFundMe is
we'll do at least one vlog.
Yeah,
with all three.
So we
Teslas
can make
it
a business expense.
Well, it won't be, because it'll be
funded. It's
a good GoFundMe.
Oh yeah.
So there, yeah, that's, just send us loads and loads
for our lavish want for something we don't need right now.
I need it.
Do you?
Well, yeah. We could start contributing to saving the planet, guys.
Yeah, if you want to save the planet, get us a Tesla.
Because I drive a lot, guys. I drive long ways. I'm polluting like fucking crazy.
I'm going to start driving a lot.
Yeah, start driving.
I'm going to buy a really inefficient car. I'm going to remove the converter.
The catalytic converter. Fuck's sake, Trott. You're
going to remove that.
Criminal.
The amount you use your battery dies every time you go back to use your car, doesn't it? You have to replace the whole car battery because it's just been left idly.
Is that an electrical fault, do you think?
No, I think it's just because it has a residual amount of like
power. Yeah,
power. But like we changed
the alarm system going
really frequently.
Well, no, it's just if it's not driven or started in like months, which on some cases it might have been, is it?
Yeah.
Then yeah, it just dies.
I've replaced the battery.
You
twice.
Can recharge the battery. You can just take the battery out, put it inside. But the thing is, normally a point where you're like, I need to use this now.
It's like acid.
So
and
you
shit
end
coming
up having
the
to buy
connectors.
Another battery. Oh, really?
They were dead.
Shit, man.
Well, I've been better recently. I've been keeping it alive,
keeping it living, keeping it going.
But if with a Tesla, I think
sure,
it would always be alive and ready.
Of course, yeah.
Lithium batteries won't create this acid corrosion.
Just create. It'd be a nice display. Outside in the car park.
Keep it
just
nicely
there.
Plugged
just,
in.
There it is, guys.
I'll have one
there.
Plug for my Apple phone, and then the other plug going to my Tesla. Be great.
And then a dongle going into your MacBook.
Don't talk about dongle.
Right,
for us. Yeah. USB-C to everything else.
Yeah.
Dongle.
A dongle for everything.
It'll be a fucking tentacle.
Oh, shit.
Fucking octopus of dongles.
Octopus of dongles out of game.
Get the dongle puss out.
Dongle puss.
Oh, let me get my dongle, but pro out. Oh,
God, we really do buy into the consumerism, don't we? Apple. We're in the walled garden. It's fucking great. We're all naked with leaves.
Well,
Apple leaves.
Your theory was that they're going to bring back the headphone port.
Yeah.
Do you think that's actually going to happen?
I think.
Do you think they're just going to?
It's not the first time.
I don't feel like they
backtracked.
Especially with the whole courage thing. I feel like they're
not letting me speak. Then.
Sorry, go on.
Bastard. No, it's too late. No, that's all I had to say, really.
I was saying with the whole courage thing, I can't imagine them. You know. Swallowing their pride and
they've done
and
it
doing.
Before. They've done
with
it before,
what?
Where they've removed a feature and brought it back. I can't remember
what it was,
but it was in discussion because of the iPhone 7. They're removing it.
Right, because I remember, you know, when they had the whole death grip thing, they just apologized and gave free cases out. But that's not the same, is it? As changing.
Well, that was a fault.
That was a fault, yeah. But I mean, well, this is kind of a fault, you know. You can't use fucking normal headphones. Well.
The fact that all the other products, the most recent
still
products,
have
still
headphone
have headphone ports.
And potentially the new iPads will have headphone ports.
And the fact that iPhone 7 is still a Lightning connector and not USB-C or Thunderbolt 3 that they're really trying to push on people.
Yeah.
Like, why?
Well, let's just get Samsung's, guys, and then, you know...
Have hand grenades.
Take them on
pocket.
A plane, yeah. Not be able to travel anywhere.
Yay. Like, the thing about the headphone port on the difference between a Mac, I think, and an Apple, what I would imagine they would argue, is MacBooks are used differently to iPhones, right? So they change to wireless because whenever you use your iPhone, you're not like usually editing or doing anything really precise. So they're like, you can use Bluetooth wireless headphones for that. But when you're using a MacBook, there's a good chance you might be doing music production or DJing somewhere and you would need it. You know, you're not going to DJ or sample stuff on a phone. So.
Yeah, but they could equally say there's a dongle for that. Do you know what I mean? Because there's a lot of, like, with those USB-C things, there's a lot of those hubs which have headphone ports on them.
There's a lot of high production you know, hardware and shit like that.
What is stopping them from being that, you know...
They didn't need to take it out.
Sorry?
They didn't need to take the headphone port out.
Well, they probably still have the space.
Did they, so they literally needed to take it out of this one, the space of that Taptic thing.
I think they put the Taptic engine in the same place. They had space. Space was at a premium, so they thought, fuck it, let's take this huge... Because it is a big connector out, because there's a lot of internal space to it. Like, as well, that you don't see, because obviously the entire length of the mic and headphone has to go inside the phone.
Yeah, but then they still haven't really, I mean, other than third party, they still haven't released something that charges and
and that's done. I'm not saying they're not making horrible decisions. I'm just saying the difference between a MacBook and an iPhone.
Oh, right, yeah, of course. Yeah, yeah. But also, what about the iPad then?
I don't know.
The same?
I think people edit and I think people DJ on iPads is the main thing. Music production.
You could
iPads.
DJ on your phone if you're that stupid.
Yeah,
like you could get the app on your phone. Yeah, wait, Trott, you've won again.
Yeah,
your controller fucked up, and you still
wanning.
You're wanning.
Wanners always not, come first.
He's not a wanner at language, but he's a wanner at the game. Thanks you
Take
for
me.
Watching us.
Thank you, Elon.
Bye.
Bye. Oh, bye.